your study in master and PhD, cite your assignment is very, very important. If you fail to cite your assignment properly, even your thesis, you will face a lot of problems. Okay, that's why you must know how to cite your assignments properly. So we have a lot of software actually. Okay, for example, Zotero. There is one software, you know, Zotero. 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 And also the EndNote. I'm also doing training on EndNote, but now I don't do because I focus on Mendeley. Okay, another software is Mendeley. Another software is a BibTeX. But the most famous one is Mendeley. So what you can do in Mendeley? Okay, actually Mendeley is not only the reference manager. It's more than that. Okay, it's more than that. Mendeley is more to library. You can do your personal library in your Mendeley for your assignment. In the meantime, you can make your Mendeley as a reading gallery. Anytime you can open article, you can read, and also you can highlight the important points, and also you can cite. There are few things, not only the citation, right? It's more than that. Okay. Normally, you know, okay, if you go to the Word, let me share the screen. Okay. If you go to the Word, okay. Even, I think you can see my screen. Okay. You go to Word like this. Even in the Word, there are one software or one plugin, built-in plugin. Built-in means when you install the Microsoft Word, it's already there. Okay, built-in plugin you can use for your citation as well. Okay, like this. You go to references. Okay, actually you can use that one, you know. Okay, this one. This is called manual citation, but you have to put add new resources. Sorry, new sources. Then you have to manually edit. Okay, for example, Matiwana and Jagannathan. Okay, title, entrepreneurship. Year 2020, city Kuala Lumpur. You have to manually key in all of this. I think you are familiar with this one. Then you click OK. You can put for the journal report and everything, you know, over here. And you click OK. Okay, you see. So when you write article, okay, let's say my name is, okay. Then you want to put any citation, okay, Mati. So you want to put citation, you can put citation over here. Insert citation, you can put this one. Okay. Then you can create a bibliography like this. You can do it in Microsoft Word, but this is very, very typical way. Okay, very, very typical way of doing. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to introduce to you the Mendeley, which is very straightforward. Actually, Diana asked me, sir, whether 2 hours is sufficient or not. Frankly speaking, 2 hours is not sufficient, okay, to tell everything about Mendeley. But I tried to compress, okay, tell the important things. I hope you can follow. Okay. Are you recording the session, Diana? Are you recording?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, good. Wait. Wait. Give me 1 minute. Okay, good, fine. Okay, this is my Mendeley library. Can you see this one? You know how many articles I keep in my Mendeley library? Can you guess how many materials? Because I use this one for my PhD. Okay, and until now I'm using for some other article writing. So can you imagine how many articles I keep in this Mendeley library? This is my library. Yeah, Diana, can you see this one? Can you, Diana?
Yes, can. Yes,
okay, good. This is the thing. Just imagine, in this my library. Okay, I don't need to buy the cupboard, you know. I keep 3,451 materials, articles, thesis, okay, journal article, thesis, conference paper, and so many materials I keep here. Not movie, yeah. Don't keep movie in the Mendeley. Okay. Never mind. So first, okay. So what you can do, I just tell you can keep the article, and you can open the article, and you can read from here, and you can do a lot of editing work. For example, you want to highlight, you can highlight PDF, and you can do, you want to write something, you can write here like a note. You want to write notes, everything you can do. That's why I told you this is beyond that, beyond citation. Okay, and you can create folder like this. Like your assignment, you can do folder by folder assignment, right? Okay, then you can keep the article according to the assignments for citation. Okay, sometimes, you know, I think most of your lecturers will reject your assignment if your citation are not properly cited. Am I right? They will reject. They will say your citation is wrong. Then you crack the head. How come lah? I want to. Okay, this lecturer asked APA. This lecturer asked, you know, Chicago. Okay, I get confused. Okay. You can do, and also you can last time, you know, there are so many functions, now limited function. Okay, so I will introduce to you one by one. Okay, that is Mendeley actually. Then after that, you have to cite. When you want to cite, you have to edit, you know, very difficult. Okay, very difficult. You see here, I just do a very simple one. Okay, let's say I have a text something like this. Okay, I have a text like this. Don't ask me how you create a text something like this. Okay, I can create, no problem. Very simple only. Random text generation. Okay. Let's say I want to cite. Normally we will cite here, right? Okay, I can go here. I can cite, you know, as many as I can. I can cite like this. Citation is already here, you see. Okay, I want to add more citation. I can cite. Okay, I can cite more citations. This is wrong, so I have to merge. Okay, if let's say I want to cite over here, this is basically, you know, references. Okay, I will, no, I just show to you, then after this I will come one by one. Okay, actually I'm creating an excitement to you, so now you are creating an excitement, so when you are excited you won't leave the session. Okay, so I want to insert citation. I go here, I want to cite all of this. Let's say I can cite. Oop, you see, all of them are cited. Now I want to, let's say I want create a reference list. So what I can do, I go to here, references. Okay, so I want to create a reference list, right? Just one button, it's automatically will be created. Oop. Finish. Okay, everything is done. If anything wrong, we can correct it. Okay. If let's say your lecturer asks, I don't want API style, I want other style, I want Chicago, you can change it. For example, Chicago. Or you want a different style, you still can add other styles as well. For example, IEEE. You can use this style as well. You see? It will change automatically. So now I'm using IEEE writing style. Now I move to APA6. APA6. If suddenly your lecturer asks, I don't want APA6, I want APA7. Okay, APA7. So it will change. That is basically citation. Okay. Okay. Now we move one by one. Okay. We move one by one. Okay. Now I go to, I don't want to use this account. Oh. Those who are having a problem, ActiveX problem, I share the link, try to use this link. Eh? Okay. Okay, I share one link, YouTube link. Those who are having a problem, ActiveX problem, watch this one and you solve your problem. Okay. Okay, to install the software, you have to go to Mendeley.com. Mendeley.com. Okay. Before that, okay, I use this opportunity. Okay, you can watch some of my videos in my channel. Okay, I share my channel, my YouTube channel. Okay, in the chat box, you can watch my YouTube channel and subscribe my channel. This one, second one. Okay. This is one of my channel video. Okay, it's me. Okay, please do subscribe my channel. Okay, as a token of appreciation. Okay, because I will upload some videos over there. Okay. So you go to Mendeley.com. Okay, accept all cookies. So what you do, you have to download the software. So how to download? You click this one, download. Okay, download. Okay, when you want to download, it will ask, you know, which one you want to download. If let's say your one is Windows, you download the Windows. If let's say you're using a Mac, download this one, Mac. Okay, download Mac. If you are using Linux, use the Linux. Okay. Okay, you click download. Just download. Okay. My internet is very fast, that's why now I can download within a second. Okay. Then this is the download one. You install. Click and install. Next. Agree. Next. Okay. Boom. Install. Can you follow, Diana? Siti? Can I? Okay. So first, okay. First download and install. Okay. So once you install, finish, and you start your Mendeley. Okay. Once you start your Mendeley, for the first time user, you have to create an account. Okay, create an account. So for that one, click register. Click register. Okay, it will go to the Elsevier. So what do you do? Okay, you register one account. Okay. Then you give your name. Okay. Your name and create a password. Okay. Then register. Okay, this password is not strong, so you have to create. Okay, you now have an Elsevier account. So I have an account. Okay. So I save. And for the first time, it will ask, you know, okay, what is your role? So my role is a senior lecturer, field of study. Okay, my field is a business management and few fields, you know. Okay. So you can choose your field of study. Okay. Normally, Mendeley used by the, you know, most of the time, you know, Mendeley used by master student and PhD student. This is the first time I teach the undergraduate student. First time. Okay. Okay. Or you can skip this step. I can skip this step. Okay. Now I have an account. Okay. So if you want to, okay, just leave it like this. Okay, this account. Now you go to Mendeley.com and you go and do like this. Okay. And put stay sign in. Okay, because I don't want every time you log in, you know, stay sign in mean the next time you reopen your Mendeley, it will open directly. It won't ask the login credential information. Okay, sign in. Boom. Done. My Mendeley. And for the first time, it will ask, you know, like myself is already installed and already installed, but you're not yet installed, right? Okay, and this one not yet installed. So what you can do? Just close, no problem. Just cancel all of this. Okay, cancel. Okay. So now you have one clean Mendeley library. Okay, can you follow? Any question?
Okay. No question, doctor.
Okay, good. So now you have a Mendeley account. So first, okay, you have to understand what is Mendeley. Mendeley, you know, there are three types of Mendeley. Okay, this is called Mendeley desktop. Another Mendeley is this Mendeley. Mendeley web. Mendeley web main. So whatever you upload here, it will be here also in library. You will have similar, okay, similar Mendeley interface over here. But what is the difference? You can cite your paper just using Mendeley desktop. Okay, Mendeley desktop. Okay, like this. Okay, for example, now I don't have a group, right? If let's say I create a group here, or I create a folder here, one folder, testing folder. Okay, and I click sync. Sync means it will connect to the internet and update, because Mendeley will function based on the cloud. It's a cloud storage. Okay, like a Dropbox.
Okay.
Now you see here, I refresh this one. You can see the testing folder here. Can you see? Testing folder here. Testing folder, because I have created a folder, testing folder here. If I create another folder, Madi folder or Madi. Okay. Okay. Now, no Madi, right? So now Madi is already here. It will sync, you know. So the beauty of Mendeley is, now you have a Mendeley desktop, you keep lot of material. Suddenly your computer corrupted. Your computer corrupted. You don't need to worry. You buy new computer and you log in, everything will come back in your Mendeley desktop like this. Everything will come back because all of your files will be kept in the cloud storage. Okay, in the internet. Okay, two version. This is Mendeley desktop. This is Mendeley web. There is another one. Okay, another one is, you go to the Apple store or you go to the Android, you can use the same account in your apps, you know, Android apps, and you can read from your handphone all of your article that you keep in your Mendeley. For example, okay, I go to the Play Store. I search Mendeley here. So Mendeley app for Android. Where is it? Okay, let's go. It should be here. Okay, wait, because Mendeley app you also can install, because we have a wait, Mendeley. Okay. Don't use that new desktop app, this is quite different. Okay. Okay. This one. Oh, okay, something wrong today. Maybe they update. Okay, but we have Android. Let's say we go to the Apple Store. Okay. Okay, it's connected to the this one, but you can install. Okay, Mendeley for the Android and also the App Store. Okay, but I don't use Mendeley app. Okay, because I don't want my computer, my phone heavy. Okay. Okay. So far I think okay. This is your Mendeley desktop. Okay, maybe you will have a question, sir. The storage of the cloud storage. How many gig I can keep the file? Okay, you can keep 2 GB. Okay, up to 2 GB. They give you free 2 GB. But my account, 10 GB. Because I have an account of 10 GB because of I'm an advisor and also the trainer for the Mendeley. If you become a trainer, you will get a 10 GB. Okay. What is 10 GB? Now I can show. If you want to upgrade your Mendeley, you can click here. Premium packages. Okay. The price is like this. Sign up for premium. You see. I'm using this one. Pro account. And every month, I supposed to pay 40 ringgit. Every month, I supposed to pay 40 ringgit. Or per year, I have to pay around 460 ringgit. But since I'm an advisor and also the Mendeley trainer, so I can save that money. Like your case, if you want to upgrade, you can go to this plus. But don't worry, now it's completely free. Okay, completely free for 2 GB. Okay, completely free. Okay. If you want more than that, you pay this one, unlimited personal. I think you can use the free one, enough already. Okay, you can use the free one, enough. Okay. Any question? Okay, no question, huh? Okay.
Not yet.
Yeah, not yet, huh? Okay. After you install, you will see something like this. In order to enable, okay. First, you have to go to tools and you can install the web importer. Okay. Before web importer, you try to install MS Word plugin. MS Word plugin means, okay, you open your Microsoft Word. Okay, remember, you have to use Microsoft Word. You cannot use the, you know, there is one, you know, free one, free Word. It's not a Word, Microsoft Word, it's another one, WPS. You cannot use your Mendeley in WPS. Yeah, you cannot use in WPS. Okay, problem. But don't worry, UUM give you free 5 license, Microsoft Word, you can use that. Do you know that? Microsoft 365. You have 5 licenses, you know, you can use that. Okay, and if you want to actually, you know, one license of Microsoft Word is 380 or 360 ringgit, you know, but UUM give you free because you are student. Okay, because I'm also conduct a training on Microsoft applications. That's why I'm telling this one. Okay, if you go to Word, you won't see. If you go to references, now you see, you don't see anything about Mendeley over here. Am I right? So I have EndNote and other things, not Mendeley, not this one. This one is different. Mendeley site. Okay, you forget about this one. Okay. So in order to create a Mendeley region, we call it region. Region. What you have to do is first close all of your Word application, then you go to tools and install MS Word plugin. Okay, then you open back your Microsoft Word. Okay, Microsoft Word. You will see references. You go to references. Oh, now you can see. Am I right? This is called Mendeley region. Okay, plugin region. Okay, now you close the Microsoft Word. Okay, and what is this? Get Mendeley site. You click this one. Okay, you get it now. And you must have an account, you know. Like myself, I have an account. Madhivanan at staff. Okay. So I can log in. So once I log in, because this is my 365 account. So once I log in, okay. open in Word, eh? Okay. Okay, you see, eh? Okay. So it will give the some guideline now. Okay. So I will have a references. When I click references, it will come over here. Mendeley site. Do you realize or not? Mendeley site over here. So what is the difference? This one and this one. The difference is this one, you have this region, okay, this region, you have to open Mendeley desktop, something like this. Okay. But when you go to the site, you don't need to open Mendeley desktop. It will connect directly to the internet. Like this. So trust this edit. Trust. Then you have to sign in. It if it asks you to sign in. So my one is already signing. So it's already signing. Okay. So that's why, you know, I can see all of this. But I use the different account. Eh? So what I can do? Okay. I can sign out. For the first time, it's going to be like this. Okay. It's signing out. Okay, sign out. Okay, I can sign out this one. So, for the first time, your case, you have to use the similar account that you have registered. Don't use a different account. Okay, sign in. It will go to the mendeley.com and my one is just now, you know, Madhivanan at staff, right? This is my original account, but I don't want, I sign with a different account. So what I will do, Madhivanan staff.uef.edu.my. Okay, so I use signing. It will directly connect to the Word. You see, it's automatic. Nothing inside because it's, you know, nothing. Okay, very simple one. Okay. So I can click this one and I can go to Mendeley library. So when I click this one, I will go to the Mendeley library. You will go to the website. Okay, like this. I don't want to open this one. So basically, there are a few functions that you can handle in your Mendeley. First is Mendeley web, Mendeley desktop, and Mendeley apps, Android or App Store. And also you can install Mendeley site. Okay. So I already teach you. Install MS Word plugin, get Mendeley. And what is Web Importer? Web Importer is a plugin that you can install in your Google Chrome or in your Mozilla Firefox. Even in the IT Safari also can. Okay. Click install Web Importer. It will go to like this. So Mendeley Web Importer is actually, I see. When you go to Google Scholar, okay, you can directly import your article from Google Scholar to your Mendeley library. I think you guys know what is journal, what is articles. Okay, you're supposed to know, right? Okay. Go here. And like my case, it's already here. So I remove first. Okay, I remove. Okay. Then I want to add. add to group. Okay, so mentally web importer, I add to group. So when I add, it will come over here. Okay, but it disappear. Don't worry. When it disappear, you click this one, the jigsaw puzzle button. Whoop. Then you click pin. Okay, pin mentally web importer. Whoop. It will pop up here. Okay, pop up here. So when you click this one, okay, it won't function unless you are in the right place. Okay, which is the right place? I will tell you later. Are you with me? Okay. Okay. So now I have tell. I told you about the functions. Okay. Now we move to. How many students in this class today? Oh, 128. Many, yeah. Very, very good. I will say good welcome for me, and also many students. Okay. Okay. First, we have to create our library. Okay. We have to create our own library. So we have to add the article in the blank space to refer and cite. Okay, you have to read first, you have to search, then you refer, then you read, then you cite. Don't simply cite. Okay, so now we have to add the article by using a different way. Okay, first of all, you can add article. There are four ways of adding the article. One is add files. Another one is add folder. Another one is a watch folder and add entry manually. And another function. Okay, there is another function, fifth function, but not here. I will tell you. Okay. First, if you want to add files, you can add files like this. Add files. For example, you have a files like this. Let's say this is your file. You have already downloaded the file, so you can add here. Choose one, hope it will be added here. See, it's already added. Okay, or you want to add many file. Out of this, you want to add many file. What you can do, you click control, or you can click shift. Click control, you can choose one by one which one you want. But if you click shift, you click here and you click here, everything from here to here will be selected. So what I'm trying to say is, you click control, very simple, click control, press, okay, click mean press the control button in your keyboard, press and hold, and you use your mouse, you click one by one, to. All will be added. Okay, so now we have around six materials. If let's say I add again the same article, is it going to be add again? No, it not going to add, it will be replaced only. Okay, for example, now six, right? I add again now one article. Let's say I add the same article. Just now six, right? I add, it's not going to be seven, same. Okay, because if you add and add, it can consume your space. Okay, consume your space. But if you add the same article, it will replace only. So now we have a library, you know, by using one way, add article. What is add folder? Add folder mean you have one folder. In that folder, you have many articles. You want to drag one shot, you can drag also. For example, like this. Okay, let me create a very simple one. Okay. Okay. I want to add folder. Add folder. I have to go to my desktop, right? So I have a desktop. So I go to my desktop. Eh? Okay. So okay. Let's say I have a folder. So I want to. There are so many articles in that folder, you know. Okay, there are so many folders. Add folders. Eh? You see here. Yeah? It's over here. Okay, add folder. I have a few articles over here, am I right? I have around 7 articles. I don't want to add files one by one. I want one entire folder, everything inserted automatically. So what I do, I click this folder, just put add. You see, everything included. Very easy task. Okay, you create your own library. Second method. Third method. Sometimes, you know, you read some books, but that books it's not available in the soft copy. So what you can do, you have to add manually. For example, book. Okay, book. Let's say title. Title is digital marketing. Author Madhivanan Jagannathan. Okay, and when you add the second author, you have to click enter. Click enter. Eh? So now, let's say Siti Aisha. Okay, Aisha. Muhammad, let's say Muhammad Ali. So, you see here, that's the problem. You see here, the computer cannot recognize. It recognize as Ali. Ali is the father. Actually, the real name is Muhammad Ali. Am I right? Okay. So what you have to do is, when you cite, it's going to be according to Ali, not according to Muhammad Ali. So what you have to do is, you have to do like this. Okay, Siti Aisha, comma Muhammad Ali. I think this is the best way. I see. Okay. But in actual, you cannot put like this or no, okay? But never mind, you can put like this, also no problem, okay? But better, this is a problem with the Asians, you know, with the four names, okay? Okay. You can put like this also. If you put like this, it's going to be like this. Okay. So I just put Siti Aisha. Okay. If that Siti Ali, very easy. But your name is normally Siti Aisha Muhammad Ali. Okay. And another name is, let's say, okay. Okay, Vijay Prakash, let's say. Two name, no problem. Okay. It will automatically detect the last name. Okay. Okay. Then you put the year 2020, pages, let's say 300 pages. No abstract, author keyword, city, Kuala Lumpur. Edition, first edition. Okay. Then publisher, Pearson. Then you save. I see. This one, without material, there is no material. But if you have material like this, PDF, you can put over here. That is one of the function. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Apart from this, okay. Let's say you do one. Another way is, okay. Sometimes what you can do, you know, you can highlight all of this, okay, whatever you want to select, you select, okay, for only this one, you just drag and drop here, or you want to drag all of this, you can drop here, you see, one document successfully imported, 1, 2, 3, three documents already imported. It become blue color. It's been imported. Okay. Or what you can do, you know, apart from that, let's say you want to drag this folder. Also can you drag and drop? It can be imported also. So you see, imported. So this one imported. See, that's the beauty of drag and drop. Okay, am I going very fast? Am I teaching you very fast?
No, doctor, the pace is okay.
Okay, okay, thank you. Okay, there is another way. I will say this is the one of the easiest way. Okay, sometimes, you know, sometimes you don't want to drag and drop. You want automate the process. Automate the process means you create one folder. When you download one article in that folder, okay, and this Mendeley will automatically upload in this library. It means it will capture. Okay, but it's automate. You don't need to drag and drop. You don't need to add the file. You just download the file in that particular folder, and Mendeley will import file from that folder automatically. Very easy one. Okay, how to do that one? Very simple. First, you create one folder. Okay, let's say import folder, or you want my article. Okay, one folder, my article. Then you go to Mendeley desktop. You go to watch folder. Okay, watch folder. And you have to look for the folder that you have created. So my folder in desktop, which is the name is my article. So I have to tick. I will tick mean once I tick, the connection between Mendeley and this folder will be created. Okay, the connection. Okay, so I click apply and okay. So now, when I download any article or any material over here, or I just copy anything and paste here, it will be imported in the Mendeley desktop. You see here, now we have 18 documents, am I right? Let's say, now I import one file to this watch folder, for example. I copy and paste. Okay, I put these two articles over here. Okay. Just now, Mendeley only 18, right? Now you see, will be 20. Wait, sorry. So I have to sync back. Okay, sometimes it will take time. Actually, it's uploading, you know, uploading in the internet. That's why, you know, it's percentage. Okay, wait. Oops, you know, okay. Just
excuse me, doctor, we have patient.
Yeah.
From Mr. Go Jilin. Hello, I am Go. I have a question. So it means that all articles have to be downloaded before added to Mendeley library for citation, right?
Okay, there are a few ways. Okay, of course. Okay, the answer is, of course, you have to download the article, okay, the document, and you have to keep, then you have to import it to Mendeley. But there is another way also you can do. You can go to Google Scholar or Scopus.com. You can use the Mendeley importer. It will be directly inserted in your library. That is another way. I will teach you later that one. Okay. Whatever is it, the answer is you have to download. Because once you download, then only you can keep in your Mendeley desktop. Okay. Okay. Okay, so let's say I download one article in this folder, watch folder. Let me try. Okay. I go to Google Scholar. I download one article. Okay, let's say I download this article. Okay, let's say I download this article. Oh, this article is not available. Okay, let me go to the another article. Okay, Google Scholar. Okay, okay, let's say I download this article, I put it in my article which I connected to the watch folder. So good. Okay. This article, right? Okay, social commerce research. So this article automatically will be here. I can search here, you know. I can go here, I can search. Okay, you see. So I did not add the file, you know. I just download into my folder, which I have been integrated. Okay, which I have integrated. It has been integrated, and I have integrated by using the watch folder function. Okay, this is one of the important. You can download as many as you can. Okay, in this folder. Okay, so now I have 21 documents. If let's say I update again, okay, this is one folder, three files, right? Okay, let's say I want to add few articles some more. I put these three and put here three, right? Okay, now you see. So these are three articles that I added. Now it's become 24 articles, you see. So that's the beauty of watch folder. I think you can follow the steps, the watch folder steps. Okay, watch folder steps. Okay. Okay. Maybe you will have a question, sir. If let's say I create a watch folder, okay, then I put the article in the watch folder, then I delete the watch folder, like this, my article, right? If I delete, is it going to delete my article from here? No, it's not going to delete your article from the Mendeley, because once you import it into the Mendeley, it will be kept somewhere in the cloud and also in your computer. If you want to see where is your article kept, okay, you can go here, file, you go to option, you can go to the file organizer, okay, you can go and check here, open folder in Windows Explorer. So your file will be kept here, will be kept here. Okay, you can change here, you can sort into the author name or journal name or year, okay, for example, like this. Okay, then you can see. So this is so much of the article, because so many articles, because my previous file. Okay, my previous file articles. Okay, so you can check here, no worries. But you don't need to worry about this one. Okay. If you have any proxy system, you can connect to the, you know, proxy to download the articles, but you don't bother about this one. Okay. This is Zotero, PipTex, watch folder, file organizer, and document details. Okay. Cancel. So now you have a library. Okay. This is your library. Okay. So already added. Okay. Last time, you know, Mendeley got a lot of functions, now no more ready. If let's say now is a 24 documents, no problem. If let's say you have so many documents. Okay, if let's say you have so many documents. Okay. If you have so many documents, it's very difficult to search. So what you can do, you can search like this. You can type the like this. Over here, you can type and it can come out. Social commerce. Or you want to search by author, also can. Okay, like this. Okay, or the you can search by author, but normally I will search randomly. Okay, I just put blank and then just search. Okay. This is your library. So now you already created a library. Okay, so now you have to optimize your library. Okay, you see here, this is your Mendeley desktop. You go to your Mendeley desktop, you will see the similar thing in your Mendeley. You see, just now I deleted the folders, so no more folder in your Mendeley web. You see, I have to sync first. Sync. Okay, make sure you sync, then only you will be updated. Okay. Now I go here and I reload. So when I reload, now you see there is no more folder. Okay. So it's going to be similar. See all the article. Okay, all the article that I kept in Mendeley desktop will be here. This is called cloud storage. So basically, I teach you how to add the articles, keep your files. Sometimes, you know, I know you guys, when you do assignment, every day you go and search the article And you keep, after that you search and keep and keep. In the end, you do not know which one you're supposed to refer. You confuse. Because so many things you downloaded. Okay. But when you organize like this, it's going to be okay. Then what you have to do is you can create a folder. Create a folder, for example, assignment. This one for the assignment. Let's say you are taking a macro. Let's say you are taking subject marketing. Okay, and you are also taking subject international business. Okay. And under the marketing subject, you have a few assignments. So what you do, you click marketing and you click new folder. So subfolder, assignment one. Assignment two. So now you have a folders. Oh, this one assignment two, right? So you can drag and drop under the international business. No problem. So now it's under the international business. You want to put under marketing also can. I see. You can rename also. Ach, grammatical error. Spelling. Assignment. Okay. So why you have to do folder? Because you are undergraduate student, so you have a lot of assignment. Like PhD is different. PhD, maybe my teaching is going to be different. So let's say you have an article, maybe you fill this material, not only article, you will download the reports, you will download from the, you know, website and so on. Okay. So what you can do? You can drag and drop in the assignment one. Okay. It's not going to be duplicated, you know, it will be keep file over here. When I click assignment one, the file is here. But the same file will be in the all document. And this is just a mirror file. It's not a duplicate. Duplicate means it will consume the space, you know. So this is just a mirror file. Okay. So if let's say you want to keep this article, these two articles, you want to keep in assignment two, you can keep. You go and drag and drop in the folder. It's going to come out like a two lines, you know. So two lines in folder means that folder. If you go up, this folder. If you go up, this folder. Okay, like this. Drag and drop. Okay. You don't ask me how to drag and drop. That is a very basic question. So how to drag and drop? Of course, you have to click the mouse and drag and drop. Release means drop. Okay. So you see, that is a folder. So I have put in the folder. But this file still will be in the all documents. See, NASCO. This document still here. And also this document still here. Okay. It's not duplicate. Okay. Can you follow? Okay.
And doctor.
Okay, good. Okay. So that's why, you know, I told you earlier, Mendeley is not only reference management software, it's more than that. So now we have a big library with the 24 materials with the folder. Okay, let's say you are doing an assignment, but you assign your friend to collect the materials. You can create a group also. For example, Siti Aisha and myself can be connected. So what I can do is I can create a group here. Create group, okay, maybe marketing assignment. Create a group, okay. Siti, what is your email ID for the Mendeley?
MS.
Okay.
Adelaide, A-D-E.
A-D-D.
L-A-I. D-E.
D-E.
Yes, D-E.
Okay.
2027.
At gmail.com. Oh, very long email. Okay. But is it correct?
Miss Adelaide, yes.
Okay, @gmail.com. Eh? So you will receive an email, you know. You check your email. And look at your Mendeley. Once you accept, your Mendeley will have folder like this. Check your email.
Not yet.
Okay, let me try my one. New group. Okay, I will show by myself. Very easy. Okay. Testing. Create a group. Okay. Let me delete it group. Okay. I can see, you know, the group testing, you see, over here. You see, I received a group invitation. Okay.
Okay, doctor.
Join the group. Okay. Okay.
So we invite people that we want to join through email, right?
Yeah, you can invite people who want to join. Then they can join. The beauty of this one is, when you keep the file in the testing, this folder, okay, this group folder, so when your friend open his or her Mendeley, he or she will see the file that you have uploaded in this folder. Not this one, this folder. Because this is the sharing group folder. You understand or not? Okay?
Yes,
so, so you don't need to, you know, send email, check this one. It's like, you know, Dropbox file sharing. You know, in the Dropbox, you can share the files, right? You can do this one. And you can cite each other. Cite. You can do citation. This is very high level one, okay? Advanced. Okay? Maybe you can try. Okay? This is called external library. This is your library. Okay? That's the thing. And another one. Can I delete this one? Oh, let's say you want to delete this file. You can delete. Oh, you accidentally delete. Okay. You delete all of this file. Oh my God, I delete everything. Can I get back? You can get back everything. How? You go here, all deleted documents. You click all deleted documents, it will be here. What do? You select all. Let's say you select all. What do you do? Okay, if you want to completely delete, you can delete documents. Okay, delete documents. Okay, otherwise what you can do, you can take it back to your folder. You can drag and drop back. Okay, drop back in all documents. Now you see all the documents completely free. And now we have this one. Let's say I delete again. Let's go here. Okay.
Doctor, there a question.
Yeah.
From Nurul Ain. If we invite that person, does she or he have to Mendeley account as well?
Pardon?
Need to have Mendeley account as well when we invite the person.
Yeah. And when you invite the person, email address that you want to invite should have an account of Mendeley by using the email address that you are mentioning in the group. For example, I put your Mendeley, I put your Gmail address, am I right, Siti? And
yes.
That email address, okay, should be used in your Mendeley. Don't give the different Mendeley or different email ID. Okay? Oh, welcome, all Dr. Right. Alisha, for your information, Dr. Alisha. Dr. Alisha, I think she's my friend. Dr. Alisha. Okay. So that's the thing. So you have to call the person who have an account of Mendeley. Don't simply call anyone. Because they cannot join the group if they don't have a Mendeley account. That's a problem. Okay.
Understood, Doctor.
Okay. So that's the thing. If let's say you want to delete completely, because when you delete your document and you put in the deleted document, better you delete. Otherwise, it will consume the space of 2 GB. Okay, you have a limited 2 GB only. Okay. So I delete document. Oop. Okay. So I have all documents. Okay. Now you know already. Sorry. Now you know already how to create your own library. Okay, now I teach you how to handle the document. Okay, how to handle the document. Oh, sorry, before that, let me tell you how to use the Mendeley import. Okay, you can use the Mendeley import, but most of the time not successful. I don't know why, something wrong. Okay, Google Scholar, let's say you go to Google Scholar. This is one of the functions you can use. Not only Google Scholar, you can even import from the Scopus.com. Okay, Scopus.com. Oh, sorry, ScienceDirect. These are the databases. Okay, that's why I need around 3 or 4 hours to conduct training, because I will teach the databases of the academic articles. I will teach how to search, and then only I will teach the Mendeley. It's an integrated training. Okay, never mind. Today I will just focus Mendeley. Google Scholar, let's say you want to search about big data. Okay. Now you want to download these articles. You want to download article about big data. Once you search, after you search, you go to this one, this button, Mendeley Web Importer. Click this one. Okay. Then you have to sign in. Sign in. For the first time, you have to sign in. Okay. Okay, I have signed in. It will capture all the article listed here. You see here? Okay, you see? It will capture and it will tell, this one available, PDF available. So you can click. Okay. You can tick, tick. This one not available PDF. So you have to, if you want download, you can download, but without PDF, only the bibliographic data. It's mean only the name, journal name, something like that. Like this. I can put this one. Okay. Then I click add. So it will add it. It will be added into my library. Okay. It's supposed to be added. Let me check. Sync. Okay. About big data, right? Big data. You see? How big data is different. It's already here. See, I did not download. it automatically download since that PDF available in the internet. And also challenges and opportunity with big data. Okay, this I see this article already. That is beauty of Mendeley web importer. So I can open. Okay, because this one with PDF. What about without PDF? This one without PDF, right? From the editor, big data and management. You see, yeah, this one no PDF, definitely. I see no PDF. Can you see the different city and the rest? Yeah. Any question?
So fun.
Okay. So that is Mendeley web importer. So I taught you how to add files, how to create watch folder, how to add entry manually, how to add folder. And I go for the advanced level, which is web importer. It can reduce your time of getting articles. Maybe you think for the undergraduate level, sometimes you use the news, okay? News article. So what you can do is, if let's say you're getting some articles or reports, okay? Reports, let's say you get the reports from somewhere, or news, let's say the Star. This news. Can I put this one, this news in the, okay. Let's say, can I put this news in my my library? Can I put or not?
Can maybe?
Yeah, you can put this one. How do you put? Very simple. So normally, what I will do, you know, okay, I will right click, okay, I will click print, okay, and I will save as PDF. Okay, and I save it in the PDF format. Okay, and put in desktop. Then I go to Mendeley desktop. Then I will add that file. This one. So it's already here. See? I can put here, okay? That's a way, one of the way, because newspaper normally in the web format, okay? Okay, once you add all of the library, okay, all of these things, you have to make sure the detail of the article is correct. Detail means, we call it bibliography. Okay, what is bibliography? Bibliographic means this one. This is bibliographic data. Journal name, sorry, the article name, the author, the, you know, journal name, and also the volume and everything. Okay, sometimes it's wrong, you know, sometimes it's correct, but most of the time it's correct. But this one is wrong, actually. You know why it's wrong? Because this is not a journal, you know. This is a conference paper. So you have to change to conference. Then, okay, there is no issue, you know, for this one, there is no issue. Okay, there is no issue. There is no pages. We have pages 552, okay, July 2003. Okay, this one correct. Then, okay, you don't need to keep save anyway, you know, just delete something like that. Okay, then you just leave it close. What about this one? This one, general name, okay? This is not, this one also a conference actually, okay? Wrong also. But don't worry, okay? But mostly journals should be okay. Okay, for the master PhD level, journals are very important. Okay, let's say this one, social technologies. This is correct actually, okay? This is correct. So you have to check, you know. You have to check whether it's correct or not. For example, this is one of the article, right?
Okay.
Okay. This is one of the article. Predicting electronic commerce adoption in Chile and SMEs. Okay. Why your bibliographic data should be correct? If this is not correct, your citation going to be wrong. Because data is wrong. So when you cite, it will take the data from here. Okay, data from here. Your bibliographic data. Okay. That's why, you know. But you can correct it, you know. There are two ways of correcting. One is you can correct it manually, or you can correct it by using the artificial intelligence system. Okay. How? Very simple. Let's say this article, nothing, empty. Okay, everything not included. Okay, it's been the data is not complete, the bibliographic data. So how you can correct it? Very simple. Nowadays, most of the article, they do have DOI. You know DOI? Normally you look at the article, they have a DOI. This is DOI. Okay, this one. Digital Object Identifier, that is DOI. Okay, so what you do when you have a DOI in that article? For example, this one already got DOI, so you can copy the DOI and paste here. Okay, for example, okay, let's say you copy from somewhere and you put DOI here. When you click this one, look up. It will be automatically corrected. You see, corrected. Just now I delete that. Just now I delete. Okay, for example, I delete like this. Okay, I delete like this. Now empty. But I did not fill up manually. I just go to the here. I click DOI. It will detect. That is digital object identifier. So before you cite the article, make sure it's correct. Okay, make sure it's correct. Understand? Okay, yeah, Siti?
Okay, pardon me, doctor. There's a question in the chat box from Miss Diana. Excuse me, doctor. I want to ask, there's certain articles that are not available to download, right? Can we use Mendeley to open them?
You cannot use Mendeley to open them. Because Mendeley is not the downloader. Okay, not the article downloader. But some article you have to pay money to download. Am I right? Are you referring to that one, Diana?
Yes.
Okay. I can teach you how to get article which you have to pay. There is one tool you can use to download the article that you're supposed to pay. You want to learn? So I have to charge extra. Okay? No. I just kidding. I will teach you. Okay, normally I will teach to the PhD students and also the master students, because UUM library, we subscribe many journal articles, okay, but not all. So some article you have to use that tool to download. I think you know about Sci-Hub. There is one function, Sci-Hub function. I can tell you, I can teach you. Okay, don't worry. Okay, never mind. Okay. Basically, this is how you create a library. I want to switch to my account. Okay, I change my account. I don't want to use this account. I want to use another account. Okay. So now you know how to create library, how to put the folder, and how to correct the bibliographic data. Okay. So before I teach you how to download the article, so I tell you something here first. Okay. Let's say you have an article like this. Okay. This is my folder. Okay. You read this article, let's say. Let's say you read this article. My article better. Okay. Okay, let's say I have an article. So now I'm reading this article. Okay, let's say I'm reading this article. Okay, so can I highlight this article? Because when you read, you want to highlight because you want to refer back that article. Okay, so what you can do is you can use these functions. For example, you can highlight. Okay, for example, you read this one and you feel this is a very important point. Okay, you can highlight. You just click highlight, then you can highlight like this. Okay. Can you change the color? Can. Purple color. This one you want to put purple color. Because I think the girls like to highlight the text. Okay, rather than a man. Okay, boy, don't bother. Okay, you can highlight. Okay. In the meantime, you can put the notes as well. What is notes? Okay, note mean you can put notes here. Okay, maybe you can. This is important for introduction. You can put notes. The next time you come, you can look at this one. Okay, that is called note. Okay. Okay, that is one of the way of doing. Okay. You can right click, you know, like this. Sometimes you can right click, you can add note also. If you want to delete, you can delete also. You click this one, you click delete. Okay, anything. Okay. So that's how you open and read the thing. It means you no need to print and waste your money for the printing cost. Yeah, you can keep in the library, you can open and you can read. If let's say you have a tab, you can just read like that. If you install the apps, very easy. Okay. So the rest you can check over here. Okay. The text means you can put the text, you know. Tag, for example, this is for the this article may be important for the two assignment. Maybe you can put for the marketing assignment one, and also you feel this article also very important for the IB assignment two. Let's say assignment two. Okay. Okay, this article, and you have another material. Let's say you have this one. This one. Okay, maybe this book. Let's say this one. You want to put tag also. Okay, maybe you can put marketing assignment. Or you want to put, I see, the marketing assignment. You can put the tag. Put. So what will happen when you want to search back by the tag? Very easy. You go here, filter by my tag. Okay, you have a marketing assignment, right? Okay. You have a marketing assignment. You click marketing assignment. That two article will come out because you already do tagging for that article. You click this one. These two article will come out. So you know, oh, this article I already tag for the assignment for marketing. You can refer back. And you can refer back the highlighted points as well. So it's more organized in terms of reading and organizing the articles. That's why, you know, reference manager, not only reference manager. Okay, Mendeley is not only reference manager, it's more to organizing the articles and materials that you want to read. Okay. So that's it for this one. Okay. Now we move how we can cite the article. That is most important. Okay. Now let's say you want to cite. There, you see, yeah, last maybe 15 or 20 minutes, I will teach you how to do citation. But this, the topic of this training is properly cite your assignments, am I right? But in order to properly cite your assignment, you have to do all of this. You have to keep the article, you have to correct the bibliography, then only you will have a proper citation. Okay? Then now you go. Okay, blank. Okay. Okay. Now I have a text. Okay, let's say I have a text. You are doing assignment, right? Definitely you will have a text, something like this. Normally you will do citations, am I right? As I told you earlier. Okay, you will do citation, something like this. Then to do citation, you go to references and insert citation. You can search the author name if you know the author name. If you don't know, you click go to Mendeley. Then you know which one you want to cite. Okay, let's say you want to cite this one. You click, select the article that you want to cite, and you click cite. Then citation created. This one become one because I choose the style IEEE. So normally in UUM, we will use 6th edition. Okay. And you want to add more here. Let's say insert citation. You want to insert someone. Okay, some more article. Cite. Okay. And suddenly you feel read. Then, oh, you want to add some more. So what you do? You click in that after the bracket. Better you after the bracket. After the bracket, insert citation. You want to add more articles. For example, you want to add this one. This one. You can add. See? But this is wrong because you see, one bracket, another bracket. You see? Wrong. So, what you have to do is you have to highlight all of this. And once you highlight, you will see the merge citation. You click merge citation. Now, okay, ready. Okay. And according to APA, it should be alphabetical, you know. Okay, not by the year. It should be alphabetical, actually. Okay, it will order in the alphabetical. Okay, if I'm not mistaken, in the APA 6. APA 7 is quite different. Okay. And also, sometimes, you know, you will do like something like this, according to. Am I right? According to. According to, normally you cite only one material. You cannot do something like this. According to Elwart, you know, Gopalku, Benitez, Holbert, you cannot do. According to just one single citation. According to, okay. Let's say it's a citation. You go to Mendeley. And you want to cite someone. Okay, let's see this one. Cite. And make sure the information over here is correct. Yeah? Now this information is correct. If let's say the information is not correct, let's say no title, let's say no author name. You see what will happen. You see what will happen. Okay. Am I right? You see, according to something like this, because no author name, okay, no author name. That's why it's become like this. This is wrong actually. So how to correct it? You cannot correct it manually. So what you do is, you go to edit citation, go to Mendeley, this one, right? Okay. You can do two ways. Okay, do it two ways. You click and you update it manually, but you don't update it manually. That is old time job. Okay, old timer's job. Okay, not right now. So what you do? You go to DOI. You click DOI, everything will be corrected immediately. Boop. Done. Okay, done, right? You see the magic, yeah? Everything corrected. Okay. Now you see automatically corrected here. Can you see the this one, Siti?
Yes, sir.
If not corrected, very simple. What do? You refresh. Refresh. But do you think this is the correct way according to like this? According to APA citation, this is not correct. So what you have to do is, you can copy or drag and drop this one. What you do? You can drag and drop an outside like this and keep manual edit. Or what you can do is, you can copy, paste. Also can. Okay. But this is not, I don't recommend this way. Better you highlight this one. Can. Okay. Then you click this one. Okay. Now you can click. Okay. Or the another way is, the best way is, normally I will do, copy, I will paste here. Okay. Then I click here and I edit the citation. Edit the citation. I click this one and I will suppress. Okay, suppress the author. Suppress means remove the author. Okay. It's going to be like this. Okay. If you don't want to do, I feel very complicated. What you do, you know, very simple. You just drag and drop here outside. Keep manual edit, then you can adjust it accordingly. But you're still making a mistake. Okay. According to Abolo, Varuna, and Manzona, this is wrong actually. You know why? APA 6, when inside the, we call it in-text citation. Okay, in-text citation and syntax citation. There are two types of citation, you know, syntax and in-text. Okay. So this one, what do you do? It's supposed to be A and D, not symbol. And outside, it should be a symbol. If you want to learn more about this one, you go to this website. Online Writing Lab, APA General Format. You go to the website, you can go. Okay, so how to, you can generate the citation, you know, journal article, you can generate the citations over here. Okay. You can put the article name or whatever is it, then you can generate. Okay, this one I don't want to teach actually, I just want to show to you. So you can go to this website and this is an in-text citation, we call it. Okay, in-text citation. This one. If you want to know what is citation, you go and read this one. In-text citation, capitalization, quotes, and italics, underlining, and a lot of things. Okay. You see. According to Joe, again, John's 1998. Okay. This one. Okay. You can read this one. So once you done these citations, okay, what you do, you know, You go here and you have to put the reference in the different page, you know. You cannot put in a same page. Otherwise, it will stitch together. So what you will do, you go to the design, layout. You have to break the page. Okay? Page break. So it means whenever you add the text here, this page will move forward. It's not going to stitch with your text. That is called break. Okay, break the page. Okay, now you see here, references.
Doctor?
Yeah.
We have 5 more minutes to wrap up. It's near the program time to end.
Yeah. It's almost end. Okay, I came to the end already. That's why I showed you the references. Okay, then you go here. Thank you, Siti. Then you go to the references and you insert the bibliography. Everything is here. You see? This one, something wrong. Walcott. So if you feel something wrong here, you have to rectify in the Mandarin desktop. Never mind, I will rectify. Walcott, right? Okay, this one. Walcott. Okay. I can go here and I can search here. Walcott. Okay. Now I know the problem. You know the problem? Because of this one. You see? In the title, it's merged with this one. So what I will do is, I will correct it like this. You see here? Now it's okay already. So now I go here. I refresh. Done. You see? Okay, ready. You see the magic. That's why, you know, even though the machine do everything for you, you have to check a little bit also whether it's wrong or not. If you feel wrong, you correct in the Mandarin desktop. You don't correct here. Don't correct in the word. You correct here, it will be automatically corrected here. Let's say, okay, then you want to make it nice, what do you do? Normally we will do. This is American style, you know. American normally, when American write the thesis, they don't normally justify. They just put it like this. But we justify. So we just justify, yeah? Okay. Oh. Now looks better. Am I right? Looks better, you see. I think everything is okay. And you should add the DOI if you do F. Okay? And one more thing, sometimes some lecturers will ask you to change their writing style. They don't want APA. They want maybe IEEE. Okay. So what we can do? You can do IEEE. Oh, change. Whatever style you want. You can change this style, 7th edition. 7th edition was quite different, you know. I see. Okay, you want more styles. Also, you can go. Okay, nature. Use this style. Done. Nature different. Okay. So, actually, that's it. Actually, I one time, you know. So if you do have any question, you can ask.